Good morning and welcome to the sixth grade chapel. We begin worship today in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please join me in the responsive reading. In the name of God the Father,
praise to our creating God.
In the name of his Son Jesus,
praise to our redeeming God.
In the name of God the Spirit,
praise to our redeeming God.
Let us join our thankful voices. We will now collect the offering as the sixth grade class sings, Who Am I?
Let's start with the riddle. What's something that you always have with you and yet you always leave behind? Not sure? Here's a hint. The answer is right at the tip of your fingers. If you guess fingerprints, great job. You're correct. The fingerprints are the skin patterns at the ends of your fingers and thumbs. If you look closely at the tips of your fingers under a bright light, you'll see some bumps and ridges that make up a pattern. These patterns have been with you your whole life, and they go with you everywhere you go. Each of your fingers has a different pattern, and nobody else has the same fingerprints as you. Those bumps and ridges also leave marks behind. You may have seen these marks on a mirror, window, or even paper if you've gotten marker or paint on your fingertips. We always leave these fingerprint marks, even if we can't see them. That's because the skin that covers our bodies, including our fingers, makes sweat and oil. That sweat and oil mixes together and covers the tips of our fingers. When we touch something or pick it up, the sweat and oil gets left behind and makes a mark that looks like the pattern on our fingertips. Our fingerprints are everywhere, on car windows just after they've been cleaned, on glasses if you wear them, around light switches, on doors, mirrors, glass tables, your smartphone, tablet, or any other shiny surface. Whatever we touch, our fingerprints remain. Most of the time, we work to get rid of those marks, wipe the surface clean, and remove any evidence that someone has been there. But what about God's fingerprints? We don't have to look very far or dig very deep to see God's fingerprints in our world. Whether we see it in his awesome creativity or the intricate design of everyone and everything, there is evidence for his existence in every corner of the universe. This morning, we would like to show you God's fingerprints in creation by sharing some interesting facts about some of our favorite animals. See if you can tell how each was specifically designed.
The horse. These beautiful working animals have a large heart, thick muscles, and strong lungs. They are clearly built to run, pull, and carry. Horses run up to 55 miles per hour, carry loads up to 400 pounds, and pull 1.5 times their body weight on wheels. Although you would imagine a lot of wear and tear from repetitive pounding, horses' hooves are uniquely designed to brace for impact. They do not feel the pressure thanks to a special feature called a frog that acts like a cushion or shock absorber while also pumping blood up their legs.
The bird. As frequent flyers, it is important for birds to be able to navigate in the rain. Thankfully, they were designed with water-resistant feathers. Some birds' bodies produce a waxy oil substance used to coat the wings to make them waterproof. Other birds have specialized feathers called powder down. These unique feathers break down into tiny particles to form an oil dust that prevents water absorption.
The sloth. Sloths spend almost their entire life in trees and are bound to fall on occasion. In fact, they fall once a week on average and can plummet more than 100 feet without injury. To put this in perspective, that's equivalent to 5 two-story houses stacked on top of each other. Sloths are also incredibly strong, 3 times stronger than people. They can lift their entire body weight with just one arm from the moment they are born.
The fox. A fox's nocturnal makeup and instincts are hard to miss. Not only do they have whiskers on their legs to help guide them through the night, they also have vertically split pupils in their eyes to improve focus and vision in dim lighting. Another feature is a layer in the eye that further assists visibility at night by reflecting light back into the retina and out again for extra illumination. Scientists also believe that foxes have the ability to use Earth's magnetic field to hunt for prey.
The giraffe. Despite their height, giraffes can sprint at speeds of 35 miles per hour. What is most fascinating is their specifically designed cardiovascular system. Giraffes' long necks require an enormous size heart to help pump blood that high. One way, valve jugular veins prevent extra blood to flow the brain when the giraffes lower down. If this weren't the case, the built-up pressure would cause the brain to rupture.
The honeybee. We all know that bees are hard-working insects, but what many of us aren't aware of is their ability to communicate. After visiting a delicious field of flowers, a bee will go back to the hive to perform a waggle dance, telling the other workers the direction and the distance of the field.
The donkey. Although donkeys are known to be stubborn animals, they are highly intelligent and not easily coaxed to do something they believe to be unsafe or unwise. Their strong memory enables them to remember both good and bad experiences, which influences their decision. They can remember other donkeys and places they haven't seen in 25 years.
The penguin. The tuxedo suit of the penguin is perfect camouflage from predators. From the air, their black feathers blend in with the dark water, and from below, their white bellies look like sunshine reflecting off the water. Penguins have specialized wings that act like paddle flippers that assist them in navigation. Elbow and wrist bones are nearly completely fused for added strength, while the penguins' powerful breast and wing muscles propel them through the water. Although most birds have light, hollow bones, penguins have dense, solid bones, which helps prevent them from floating. Penguins are one of the most streamlined animals in the world. They even have glands behind the eyes to filter excess salt out of their bodies.
The elephant. Elephants are perhaps the most gentle and empathetic creatures in the animal kingdom. They are known to grieve deeply over loss, bravely protect those in need, and exude joy. An elephant's temporal lobe, where memory is processed, is the largest of any land animal. This helps them recognize dozens within their herds, as well as remember friends, enemies, and important places such as food and water locations over incredibly long distances. These emotionally complex giants can also problem solve, sing, and even paint.
The bear. Bears hibernate during the winter months when food is scarce. They instinctively know that when fall arrives, they need to pack on as many pounds as possible to prevent starvation. During this time, bears will eat up to 20,000 calories per day. When the time is right, they will dig dens that are large enough to fit inside to help retain heat. During hibernation, calcium is recycled back into their bones to prevent bone loss, and nearly all muscle mass is retained.
The sheep. Believe it or not, sheep were never intended to grow wool continually and require constant shearing. Wild sheep coats are much less dense than these animals actually shed their wool each year. The sheep's eyes have rectangular pupils that provide it with amazing peripheral vision to evade predators. When sheep are ill, they can even medicate themselves by seeking out plants that will cure them.
The dog. There are few friendships more binding than that of a dog and its person. Research has shown that petting a dog can lower a person's blood pressure and heart rate, reduces stress and anxiety levels, and boosts immunity to protect against illness. The compassion, loyalty, forgiveness, and gentleness of these remarkable animals is unlike any other animal.
Although each of these animals is a marvelous design, God saved the best for last. He created people in his image with a depth of love that's unsurpassed.
The same God who spoke into existence majestic mountains and crashing waves, saw fit to breathe life into every human heart, then offer us a free gift of grace.
Since we're all sinners who fall his glory, we do not deserve his goodness.
Yet Jesus willingly stepped down as a sacrifice in our place to extend hope and forgiveness.
If we turn away from our sin to follow him and trust what he did for us on the cross,
we can rest assured of an eternity spent in his presence, for he paid the ultimate cost.
We see God's fingerprints through creation. They are impossible to miss. He loved us enough to reveal such beauty and wonder.
He certainly does exist.
Join me in prayer, followed by the Lord's Prayer. Heavenly Father, I believe you are the gracious creator of everything, and I stand in awe of your goodness, grace, and mercy. May I never struggle to see and appreciate your fingerprints all around me in each day. Thank you for creating me to be different from everything else on earth, just like my fingerprints. Help me discover my unique gifts and the purpose you have for me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom.
kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Please stand for the closing song of God of Wonders, followed by the doxology.
Water.